Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see some Java programs to display the string patterns on the screen. We already discussed how to display the number patterns. Okay, various number patterns has been discussed in the earlier videos. You can watch that videos before you go through this. Okay, so that it will be helpful for you to solve the string patterns. So come on, we'll go to the video. Now you're going to take the first pattern here. You got 5 rows and 5 columns. Okay, since it is string, you will always start with the index value that will be from 0 to whatever character, how many number of characters. So here you can see blue J, it is 5 characters, so index value will be from 0 to 4, right? And you can see the first row, it has the full string, that is blue J has been displayed, and second row it is, you can see that blue is displayed, J is missing. And then you can see BLU in the third row, and then you can see BL and then B. Okay, so here you can notice it is a decreasing pattern, it's a decreasing triangle. So how to solve this? You have two methods to solve this. One is same like your number pattern, you have to use two loops, nested loops, and you should know the I value, start and end value, and whether it is increasing or decreasing. Then you should know the J value, that is inner loop, whether it is increasing or decreasing, and the start and end value of J. And then inside the loop, you will have a system at parental end. Normally, you will display J value in a number pattern, but here you are going to use charret method, okay, which will extract the character in that index value, whatever you are giving in the parenthesis, and will be displayed. That is only difference here in the first method. The second method, you are going to use only one loop. Okay, and you are going to extract the string, not the characters, you are going to extract the string using the method substring. So we are going to see both the methods for one or two patterns. Okay, so that you will understand how to use this, and you can select your own method. Now first we will discuss the first method, how to solve this. We already discussed in various number patterns, the same thing here. Okay, if you see any pattern, string pattern, just replace that characters with the position values. Say for example, you can see blue J, just replace it with the position value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, first row. Second row will be 0, 1, 2, 3. Then third row it will be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 1, sorry, 0. Now when you see as numbers, it is very easy for you to identify whether it is increasing or decreasing, start and end value of both the inner loop and the outer loop. Okay, now when you take the outer loop, I value will be this top to down, that is you have to see the rows, right? So from top to down you have to see whether it is increasing or decreasing and what is the start value and end value. Now you can see the pattern, you can see that last character is J and then E, then U, then L and B. That means it is decreasing, right? So it is decreasing. So since it is decreasing and the first row has for complete, that is all the characters, you are going to start with 4. Okay, the index value of 4, fifth character is 4, then the next row it is 3, then 2, then 1 and 0. So I value will start from 4 and end by 0, and then it is decreasing. Now J value, you can see that it is blue J which is increasing, right? So it starts from the 0th value and then ends at the 4th position, and it is increasing. So this is how you are going to use the loops, and instead that you are going to use charret method. Okay, we are going to see how to do that in the blue J. So this is the program for the first pattern. So you have to declare a variable, string variable, and define the value inside, because it is already given in the question what is the string. So you can directly define it in the program itself. So you can give blue J. Since you have the value on the in the program itself, you know what is the start value and end value, so you no need to use n or length. You can directly go with the numbers. So you are going, as we discussed earlier, the outer loop will have the I value, which will start with, the loop will start with 4 and end when it becomes 0, and it is going to decrease. Okay, so I equal to 4, I lesser than or equal to 0, greater than or equal to 0, I minus minus. Now inside that inner loop, you will have J equal to 0, that is the start value, and ending at J less than or equal to I, because every time it is decreasing, right? So first time I value is 4, the position value is 4, so it will have complete string. And then the second time I value decrease by 1, so it becomes 3. So second time the row will be from 0 to 3, then 0 to 2, then 0, 1, and then finally 0. So when then the loop stops. and it is increasing, right? J plus plus. Now inside the loop, this is only difference between the string pattern and the number pattern. Here you are going to use str dot char at j, because normally in number pattern you just use j. Here you have to use str dot char at j, and then you can leave a space if you want, and then you should have a break for the line. So you are using system dot printer line so that it will break the line after printing the first row. Okay, so it goes on like that. We already discussed in number pattern how it works. So we'll go to the execution. So you're compiling it. No syntax errors. Close it. Execute the program. Now you can see the blue J pattern on the screen. Okay. Now you're going to go to the second method, that is using substring. Okay. Here you can see the same thing. String str equal to blue J is been defined. Now you, as we discussed in the slide, we are going to use only one loop which will start from 0 and end with 4, and it is increasing. Now this is what you are going to observe: str dot substring. You will have two arguments. You already know about string how it works. If you have two arguments, it will be m comma n minus 1. Okay, so if you have, for example, if you have 0 to 5 means it will extract the characters from 0th position to the 4th position, because it is 5 minus 1. Okay, since you have 5 characters and the position value starts from 0, if I put 4 minus I, it will be 1 character less, because it is already 4 minus 1 and then minus I, right? So I am going to give as 5 minus I. The reason for I is every time you are going to reduce the pattern, right? So I value is 0. Okay, so 5 minus 0 is 5, and already according to substring it is 0 comma 5 minus 1, so it becomes 4. So 0 to 4 will be executed for the first time. Second time when the loop executes, I value becomes 1. Now the substring value will be 0 to 5 minus 1, that is 4. And according to substring, the rule is 4 minus 1, that is 3. So 0 to 3 will be extracted. So it will extract the exact full string, and then it will be displayed on the screen. That's the reason you are using println inside the loop. Okay, now you are going to compile this. Execute the program. So you can see the pattern displayed on the screen. Now you are going to go to the second pattern, okay, which is also similar. You have two methods, charret method and substring method. Now you will observe the pattern. Okay, you will have same blue J, but here the second row you can see the start value is missing and the ending value is same. You can see that the final all the rows ending value is same, but the start value is different. So when you write the I value, you will start from the 0th point, because you can see that it is increasing manner, right? Pattern is in increasing manner, so you can write from 0 to 4, that will be the I value, it is increasing. And J value also, you can see blue J, that is also increasing, so your J value also will be from 0 to 4. And you have to notice one more thing, you are ending with the final value, that is 4 is confirmed that you are going to end it till 4, but the start value will differ. First time start value is 0, 0th position, that is B. Second time it is not 0th position, it is first position. So it is nothing but the I value. Okay. So you can write J equal to I, and then J less than or equal to 4. Okay, that is only difference. You are going to go to the program and see how it works. So in blue J, we have created a program for that pattern. You are going to initialize blue J into the string str. And then the outer loop will be from 0 to 4, it is increasing. Okay, so inner loop we can see that J equal to I, J less than or equal to 4, and J plus plus. So this is also increasing, but the start value is different, but end value is same. Okay, and then you are going to use that str.char at J, and then you are going to leave the line after the row. So you are going to compile this. So execute the program. So you can see that first row it is blue J and second row it is LUEJ and UEJ like that. Okay, so you have got the output for this question. Now you are going to go to the next method, that is substring method. Here same logic here, that is you are going to use the string and store it into str, that is blue J is stored in str. Then you are going to use the same loop, like you are going to start with 0 and end it when it becomes 4, increase by 1. Now here you can see the str.substring, the count is being changed. You can see the argument, it has been changed. It is I comma 5. Okay, so I comma 5 means first time the position value of I is 0. So 0 comma 5, that is 5 minus 1, that is 4. So first time it will print all the, extract all the complete string and it will be displayed. Second time I value is increased by 1, so it becomes 1 comma 4, that is 1 comma 5 minus 1. So 1 comma 4, that means it will print from the second character till the last character. So it goes on like that, okay, till the end. So you are going to compile this, no syntax errors. Now you are going to execute it, right? So you got the output on the screen. So blue J and then L U E J, then U E J like that, right? Okay, so you are going to go to the last one, that is the, you got one more pattern. So you are going to the pattern 3. Here you can see that the full string is not there, but you can see the characters available. That is first row you can see J, okay, second row it is E, then that is it is in reverse order, okay, then third row you can see U U U, then L L L L, then B B B B B, alright. So how to display this? Here the second method will not work because it is not, you are not going to extract the full string, you are going to extract only the characters. So only the first method can be used here. And we already seen one pattern like 1 2 2 3 3 3 in number program. So here there what you will do is you will display the I value instead of J value, right? So here also you are going to do the same thing, you are going to display the I value. But what is I value? So you can see the row here. You can see the first column. So first row it is J, second row it is E, then U, then L and B. That means it is decreasing, starts from the 4 till the 0. So your I value will be from 4 to 0. What about the J value? It is from 0 to 4 because you can, it is an increasing pattern. Okay, normally in increasing pattern it will be from 0 to 4. So you can go on with it. Okay, so where to start and where to end? That's the question, right? So here you are going to start from the fourth position, and then the second it will be starting from the third position till fourth. That means you are going to start with J equal to I and J less than or equal to 4. Okay, so second time it will be J value will be equal to I, that will be 3 because I value is decreasing. So automatically what happened, it lets you 2 times, so 3 and 4. Then third time, third row it will be 3 times, that will be I value will be 2 and end with 4, that means 2 3 4. So it goes on like that, and you can see that the result, it is increasing. Okay, the pattern also will be increased and it will be displayed on the screen. So we will go to the blue J and see how it is. So here you can see that string str is equal to blue J has been defined, and then you can see the outer loop, it is I equal to 4, I greater than or equal to 0, I minus minus, so it is decreasing. And here you can see that J value is equal to I, J less than or equal to 4, J plus plus. So first time I value is 4, so 4 and it is J value is less, not less than 4, but it is equal to 4. So it will execute one time because next time J value becomes 5. So 5 is not less than or equal to 4, it will stop. Second time J I value will decrease for one time, that becomes 3. So here now it will be J equal to 3, J less than or equal to 4, yes it is. So it will execute 2 times, 3 and 4. Third time J value, I value will decrease by 1, so it becomes 2, so it will becomes 2, 3, 4, so it goes on increasing. The same thing you are going to do, char at I, okay, str.char at I will extract the character from the position of I value, that is I, that is you are not going to extract J value, you are going to extract I value. So you are going to compile this, no syntax error, now you are going to execute the program, click OK. Now you can see that pattern has been displayed. Okay, first time you can see first row it is J, second row it is E, then U, U, U. You are going to display the I value on the screen. Okay. Hope you understood the programs, string patterns. You can try out many string patterns available with these methods. Any one of the methods can be used. You can be use either the first method, char at method, or you can use substring method. Whichever way, you just understand how to solve it. And it is very easy to solve. So we will meet you in the next video. Till then, thank you.